Hello friends, this is Pragati Yadav from Sri Vaishnav Institute of Forensic Science, and today I am going to explain you about RAM and its importance in digital forensics. What is RAM? RAM is a type of computer memory that can be accessed randomly. That is, the byte of memory can be accessed without touching the preceding byte. RAM is a form of computer data storage that stores data and machine codes which are currently being used on your computer screen. RAM allow items to be read or write in almost the same amount of time irrespective of physical location of data inside the memory. Actually, RAM is as I have said earlier that RAM is a computer's own memory. It is not the external memory source that we insert in the computer and then we store the data in that. RAM is the computer's own memory. So it is very beneficial because it allow data item to be read and write almost in the same amount. It doesn't matter that where they are located in the storage device. In contrast with other direct access storage media such as hard disks, CDs, DVDs and other older magnetic tapes which we are not using yet, these require time to read and write data items depending upon the physical location where they are stored in that physical drives. These are the limitations of machines such as media rotation speeds and other factors. These are influenced by these. RAM are of two types, first DRAM and second SRAM. DRAM, dynamic random access memory. The term indicates that it must be constantly refreshed. Means we need to constantly refresh the data. Data means on the screen, and it is the main memory of the computer device. As we have seen the advertisements of various cell phones and PCs about that, they are giving us 4GB RAM, 6GB RAM, 16GB RAMs. What these RAM are about? These RAM are all dynamic RAM. These are the main memory of the device. These dynamic RAM is the main memory of the device, and this affect the speed of the system. That's why it is required to have the more GB RAMs. Suppose means that 6GB RAM is better than the 4GB RAM because 6GB RAM have the more speed as compared to 4GB RAM. SRAM, static RAM. Static random access memory. While DRAM is typically used for the main memory, SRAM is used for the cache of the system. It is a static device. It is said to be static because it does not need to be refreshed. As we have seen in the DRAM, it need to be constantly refreshed, means thousands of times per seconds also. Both these two types of RAM are volatile in nature, means when we power off or turn off the computer system, these both memories are volatile, so we lose the data. Random access memory is a form of computer data storage. The information stored contained is volatile, meaning it can be easily be flushed when the system is power off and is not used for long-term storage. Any actively used information or data by a computer program or hardware device will run through the system's RAM at the time it is being used, and this is the main reason why RAM is so important in digital forensic investigations. Digital experts understand the importance of remembering to perform a RAM capture on a screen so as to not leave valuable evidence behind. Capturing of RAM is the basic principle for the for the investigation. Through RAM capture, the investigative officer get the information about the working time, about the browsing histories, encryption keys means the codes or passwords which they were using to unlock the system, unlock the files, and chat messages. Means due to criminals can chat through messages. We can get that messages through RAM capture and clipboard content, runtime system activity, open network connections, and recently executed commands. When the investigative officer reached at the crime scene and he captured the RAM. So through further analysis, we may get the password and current network connections information. So through these information, we get the IP address and port number of that particular connection. And suppose the criminal is working on one computer and is communicating with another computer, or another two criminals are communicating, and if they have the remote destination, then this information is very crucial for the digital forensic evidences. List of running processes while RAM capture. A list of active or running programs on the capture tell us about how the system was being used. When the investigative officer reached at the crime scene, then he got the superficial information about what was running on the computer, like Firefox, Outlook, LimeWire, all that. Later, further investigations also done on the computer, on the RAM. Username or password. Think about how many times that user uses the username or password to access an account, whether it is for the local system, means he is communicating to the local system, or it is of a local system name, username or password, or is of a remote system. These informations are very crucial for the investigative purpose. The authenticity is used to access emails. If we got the username or password informations, we could access to the emails, social networking accounts, and the access point from where the criminal is accessing to different computers. We can get that point. Content of an open window. This would include any keystroke into the web, an email clients, values into a form field, and an IM chat clients or chat stations between the criminals and between the criminal or victim, between the criminals and including participants, that how many are participating in these all chat stations and chat clients and all that. And this list could be extensive. Open registry keys for a process. Suppose the person was performing any process, then he has used that these registry keys. So it is important to identify the method used by malware to sustain reboots. And we should keep this in mind that registry keys are those that are open at the time of RAM acquisitions. Unpacked and decrypted version of the program. However, every file that is read in an executed will have to unpack or decrypt itself to run. Means if any file is encrypted, then it must be decrypted to run that file. So through these, if any file is malicious, means any file is in doubt, then we need to decrypt that file. These files can be decrypted by analyzing through static analysis or by scanning with antivirus tools, so we can unpack or decrypt these all versions of a program. These are all the crucial information that the particular investigative officer could get from the RAM capture. Thank you.